Hello, so I am currently waiting for parts for this submarine function or a signal generator. But in the meantime, I wanted to make some new content, and today I want to show you how I built this Dimble tester, because I have got some requests on this tester, how I built it up and how the circuit works. But before I show you how I built this unit, I want to show you some dangers behind working with high voltages, even if you got a Dimble tester like this. You always have to have in your mind that you are working with very high voltages, and a unit like this signal generator that got tube circuit most often have elevated voltages. So just a short demonstration here. So to show you some of the dangers when you're working with old equipment like this, I have hooked my frequency generator to the Dimble tester, and it's hooked up to my isolation transformer. And I'll show you with my Fluke 196C scope meter here some of the voltages on the chassis of this old frequency generator. That's most likely because of some leaky or broken caps inside. So turn it on here, and you can see I've got mains in, and you see I measure DC volts here, and I will touch my probe onto this nut here on the frequency adjustment. There you see, I got 191 volts DC. So if I had put my hand down here to reach a screw, or taken my screwdriver to adjust something with the power turned on, I would most likely got a great spark or get electrocuted by this nut here. So you see the voltage is building up, almost 193 now. So something is most likely leaking inside the unit. So even if you got the Dimble tester, you're not 100% safe. You have to know what you're dealing with and take your precautions, so you don't hurt or kill yourself. Of course, the Dimble tester will limit the current. That's the AC current in, and this here would most likely sap me quite good. So and we most likely got some AC voltage also. We can see here, got almost 50 volts AC. So be careful. So with that in mind, let's take a look on how I built this Dimble tester. Okay, so here is my schematic for a Dimble tester I made. Quite simple. So we got your mains in, with a fuse on the isolation transformer, one-to-one. Then you got your variac with a fuse. Then your output. Then you connect your dimbled tester to the output of your variac. Where I have my power in to the dimbled tester with a double pole, single throw switch. So this is my original plan for switches, but I had this three-way switch laying around, so I used this one, because then I could use one switch rather than two. But here I have designed with a double pole, single throw for on-off. Then I got a double pole, double throw. So this switch is to be able to bypass the bulbs or connect via the bulbs. Then I got two switches here for the bulbs. Switch 3 and 4. Then I got a current meter. Then I got a voltmeter here, both in one, but you could use two single meters, one for current or and one for voltage. Then I got my device under test input here. So yeah. There's not much to this, and it's a quite simple circuit. So we can open up the tester underneath and take a look. So I will start with taking my bulbs out so I don't crush them. I rather not have glass all over my desk here. So. Or bench. So I have glued every part of my case except the bottom cover, so I can easily take it off. So here's inside the dim bulb tester. It's simply wired up with a point to point. And I have soldered all the connectors except for inside the bulb sockets and my output socket. So, yeah, it's not much to it, but it can save your equipment and may save you. But as I said before, don't work with mains voltages if you don't know what you are doing. So yeah, this was a short overview of the circuit and how I made my dim bulb tester. So feel free to make your own. But stay safe. See you next time. Bye.